hallway. Can you please not use that as an entrance? Yes. That's between those students and their teachers. But I don't want students going through that. Okay, that's an office. You're not in trouble. I'm not tripping about it. Sometimes those other students for teachers and they keep them in there and stuff. And other students might do it, but no one addresses it. But as far as I'm concerned, I don't want students going through that. Okay, thank you. What was your question?
I honestly like to wear it like this.
Oh, great.
Oh my God, I still can't get used to that.
This is kind of hard to put it over the body of the back of the room.
Yeah.
What are you wearing?
This makes it easier to carry my headphones when I don't want to wear it and want it. And also, my battery pack. Oh, and I forgot that.
You're the one with the battery, just like what?
I put it in here this morning, I forgot that I had it.
You two, why are you wearing that?
Oh yeah, I forgot your name. Hope you don't mind me.
No, that's fine.
I heard this is what the Monkeys are actually, like a lot of open this way. Yeah. It's easier to open that way. Yeah, this place is stupid. And sometimes I love it, experience. Yeah, sometimes this like breaks off and like how do I
would imagine.
Yeah, pinch the bottom.
Someone put a whole bunch of candy wrappers behind the pinch. Good morning.
Good morning. Hey, I got a question for you.
What?
Why are you looking at me all suspicious like? Are your ceramics, are your pieces, any of the ones that are being sold?
Have a whole table in the front of the ceramics room that's being sold. All my stuff.
Okay.
Please buy me.
I'll at least check it out.
I've made some money.
You made
already.
Money off that? Right on money.
Well, you get to sell your stuff. What the heck? You got it open up. And right now. Yeah. I already made some money this morning. So can I sell my art?
Well, that would be between you and the ceramics teacher.
Yes. How about it today?
Well, I guess there's the answer to your question.
I'm in art.
You're asking the wrong, well, if you're directing it to me, then you're asking the wrong person. I don't know. If you're asking Libby,
you might have to ask Miss
Miller about art. Okay,
then why are you asking?
But no one's going to buy it.
Yeah.
Well, that's a really bad attitude. I don't even go into business that way. Now I'm going to open a restaurant, but no one's going to come in here. What is the name of the restaurant going to be? No one wants to come in here.
Yeah. I'd actually go to a restaurant.
Don't buy any of them. If you have art and you want to sell it and you think it's sellable, why don't you talk to one of the art teachers and see if you can show your art? Because we have an art gallery that students can show art at. And if the art's good enough, they might let you hang art in there.
Okay.
What kind of art do you do? Is it drawings, paintings, what?
It's art you do in class.
Okay. I take it in an art class at San Juan?
No, here.
In here? We did art in here?
No, here.
Oh, in your art class here. Gotcha. Yes. Gotcha. Okay, I have taken roll. Guys, take out your books.
Whoa!
You don't have to be here.
Can I do one?
No, you can go up to the office. You can sit in the middle room there at the VPs and you can sit. You're not in trouble. I didn't kick you out, but you don't want to. If you want to be here, y'all need to take out your books.
Yeah. I left my book at home.
Then you can go to Mrs. Ludwig's and you can ask her if you can borrow a book from her.
She's not here.
She's not here?
No.
Well.
Look behind the printer. You're right there.
can't even kiss it.
Yeah.
Hold on, is that Sam's?
Because I got one.
It's all wrappers.
No.
It's all wrappers? Hold on.
Sam's kind of coming out.
Down.
You know, period. What does Sam have right now? I think I'm going to have to call him back here. Should I call him back? I don't want to.
Yeah, call him back.
Yeah.
That's incredibly rude, man.
Yeah, he's wasting your time too with the wall.
You're not wasting my time. Do you guys understand why this
is
really
bad?
It's just basic respect. I think in this world, a lot of people have basic respect for one another. We have failed. We have forgotten what it means to be civil. Like rolling your eyes while I'm trying to make a point here that I hope that you guys can like embrace and then apply in your own lives. Because I think if you can be basically respectful to people, you guys will be more successful in life. I think you guys will be happier. You'll make the people around you happier. I get that. But there are some very respectful teenagers out there.
Yeah, I agree.
I don't know about all that.
Anyway. So if you guys can take out your books.
Any certain page you want us to open up to?
You know, Tyler, I can't even get books. I can tell you what page, but when I got 1, 2, 3, 4 people, all with cell phones out, not on their books, I have a real problem with that.
Yeah.
Like, it makes me want to just start some draconian rule that everyone thinks, God, Wallace is an asshole. Why does he do this?
I don't think it will.
But it's like, you know, if you can't just kind of do a basic thing, then I guess I gotta be an asshole. Ernesto, I'm gonna help you out, brother. There you go.
Damn.
You may have my book. Would you like to share with someone? I don't have a problem.
Did you talk to him?
Do you want to share with Patrick? You might want to ask her
for an email.
I'll email him real quick. I'm literally going to send him your stuff. Just give me a minute, okay? Mr. Wallace, I will take roll if you have
a book. Yeah,
she's my friend.
That's really cool.
Good morning, Mrs. Savage. I'm so sorry, bud. Would you be willing to send Sam?
No, you can hold it, but I'm going to have to buy it.
You can see that it's probably not anything. You may get everything covered up, and you're going
to
be
using
the blue. Yeah.
So what?
Thank you.
Just have a seat at the desk and wait patiently for a minute, please. Thank you. Libby, come sit in your spot.
Yay.
It's good for me somebody to talk to that, but it's been really lonely.
I just had a really bad fasting experience, so if you don't mind. It was a rough fact.
That's it. Slam your stuff there.
Yeah. Mr. Ross.
Make all of us feel your pain because you're mad at her.
I'm mad at Chris.
We're mad at you.
For making us take our books.
Just kidding, Mr. Wallace.
Man, I'm hungry. Is it not?
What?
What page, Mr. Wallace?
Just a second. 237. 237. There we are. What is a corporation? You guys remember what a corporation is? 237. Page 237. Chapter 7.
Remember, it's treated like a person.
Very good. You listened.
Yeah.
Wow. You could get a wow also if you listen. But you're always so
my friends come to open house, you better not say anything about it.
You better say something, Mr. Wallace.
That's all I'm not.
Have I? In the past?
No.
Yes.
Why?
To save my ass. Getting whooped.
Why?
Because you're nice.
What? it's not about being nice. It's about because, you know, I'm going to cut you guys some slack. And I know that I can't get perfection every day in class. I'm not always going to get you guys at your desk. But I'm going to ask you guys something. I want you to think about something, okay? This is what I talked about, basic respect. It's because I respect you guys as human beings. Okay? Now, when I ask you guys to put away your phones, when I ask you guys to take out your books, when people stuff candy wrappers behind the printer, like I sit there and I think to myself, and I know the answer, it's just like, because we are imperfect. Me too. We make mistakes. Sometimes we don't think about things. But at the same time, I just think like, each day I'm dealing with this stuff over and over and over. And as a human being, I get frustrated. Okay? But I will try not to take my frustrations out on you guys. Right? Because I respect you guys as human beings. Now the question is, and here's the thing, like, I've conditioned myself over the years to believe this way, to think this way. I've had a lot of life experiences. You know, one of the things I learned was when I worked at group homes, is there were some kids who had some really, really crappy lives, who had to deal with a lot of crap. And they would get mad about this stuff and they would act out. F you, you know, you tell them something like, hey, can you move it a little faster? We're heading out to a van, and they turn around, F you, mother effer. And then they would start attacking you personally, and you'd sit there and I'd think there. You know, and like I'm thinking to myself, if this was any, like if I was walking into a restaurant right now and someone did this, I'd knock them the hell out. But no, no, I'd have to stop myself and I have to think, you know what? This kid has been through a lot. And right now they're not directing this at me, they're just angry with the world. And I get that. So if I respond like they're responding to me, is that gonna help things?
Yeah.
Am I angry at the world?
Yes.
No. I didn't have to deal with what they had. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I didn't go through the kind of abuse they went through as kids. I was lucky. You know? So, but sometimes I got to remind myself of that. What I'm saying is you got to be mindful about how you treat others and how you handle your business as you go through life. Be mindful about it. Take time to think about this stuff. Okay, because I take time to think about, hey, what I tell your parents is going to have an impact on you and your life. If I send you to the office, if I, you know, it's everything, every action, there's a reaction. That's my segue into the economy. Same thing happens in the economy. For every action, there's a reaction. If you make a change somewhere, you guys have been following the news, right?
Yeah.
You guys know about the word right now.
The shooting at the YouTube headquarters?
No, not the shooting at the YouTube headquarters. That'd be a...
It was like
this. Yeah, it's our own.
They shot up the place because they banned gun videos.
Do you think that they shot up the place because they banned gun videos?
Well, that's what they said.
That's what they said? Okay, do you think someone goes like, I'm sitting there, and let's say I'm Wallace. You guys know me, right?
No.
And one day I get up and I'm like, I'm gonna go to YouTube and shoot it up. You think that's the reason?
Well, that's not the reason.
That what I'm saying is that's not the reason. Just like those kids who are yelling at me at the group home, telling me to F off to do this. Do you think at that moment they're mad because I said, hey, can you speed it up?
Oh yeah, just right here. I just saw it. Three women and someone injured and two women killed.
Well, the shooter shot herself.
Oh, yeah.
That's the person who died. It was, yeah, you know, there's some bad stuff that's going on in this world. Economically speaking, there have been tariffs imposed upon the Chinese. Who is it affecting specifically? California, there are people. There is a group in California who is very worried about how the Chinese are going to react. You know who the people are? They are farmers. In middle America, there are people who are very worried because a lot of our pigs, a lot of our hogs, pork products are sold to the Chinese. A lot of soybeans. You know how you guys go to Chinese restaurants and eat tofu?
Yeah.
You know what tofu comes from?
Pig.
Nope. That's a good guess. I get it. Looks like it could be animal fat. No, it's a plant protein that comes from soybeans. Soybeans are a plant that grow about this high. So if you guys are ever driving through the Central Valley down I-5 to LA, you're not going to see a lot of soybeans because most of the fields are grown in the eastern part of the Central Valley. But you see a plant about this high, that soybeans. What they do is they take that soybeans and they mash it up and they add water to it, and then it creates this kind of like paste, this muck. That's tofu. And the Chinese eat a lot of tofu. Americans eat a lot of tofu at Chinese restaurant. People who are into healthy. You guys ever eat tempeh? You guys know what tempeh is?
I've never tasted tofu.
You've never tasted tofu?
It doesn't really have any flavor.
It doesn't. It's a very versatile, if you guys want a fairly inexpensive protein source. You take some tofu, and if you mix it in with certain sauces, it'll take on the flavor of that sauce. It's kind of like a sponge. It's like a block. It looks like a block of white jello. Yes?
Put it in like a fried rice or like stir fry.
It looks like rice to me.
It'll look like eggs.
Yeah. It can be good. Here's what I would suggest. You guys fry it. You take it, you put a little oil, not olive oil. I go like walnut oil, some kind of nut oil, and sear it.
Stop.
We did this during second period. Sear it, get it, and it gives it a little crunch to it. And then you chop that up and add it to like a stir fry or something, and it's good. Anyway, that's an economic issue. There's an action for every action. The action is the Trump administration has imposed, Donald Trump specifically, has imposed higher tariffs on the Chinese.
Oh, yeah.
Because we buy a lot of Chinese products. I bet right now, each of you, you took off your pullovers and looked at the back, the tags, I bet it says made in China. Seriously. Your gadgets, maybe your shoes, and even some products that are American, like Nike shoes, you know where most of those are assembled?
In China?
Nope.
What's it called?
Nope. India.
India.
Okay.
The shoes are assembled in India. They're usually assembled, American products are assembled in third world countries where they don't have as stringent environmental or human rights standards. And this is one of the kind of ugly truths about business in America. A lot of the products that people buy are bought, are paid for by the sweat and labor of people who are less fortunate in other countries. All right? But that also allows us, it allows companies to have higher profit margins, so they're not going to charge you as much. But like Nike, for a pair of Nike shoes, when you look at, you know, minimum, you're going to spend $50, typically about $150, $250. Imagine the profit margin for that. If they're assembling them in India, they're probably getting, it's probably costing Nike pennies on the shoe. So for pennies to create it, they're making $100, $200 off of us. All right? All right. With that said, we're going to look at corporations.
Is it like the Chinese, like the president or whatever his name is? Like, isn't Trump like escalating war with them or something to be like trade?
We're not looking at war. There are people. I mean, it could, you know, probably the uglier thing, the more dangerous thing is our relationship with North Korea. And the thing is, like, if we go to war with North Korea, they border China. Hey, I have a question. I'm not accusing you of this. I just want you to tell me the truth, because I can't imagine anyone else did this. You've been eating a lot of Reese's peanut butter cups, okay? Question, have you been stuffing the wrappers behind the printer?
No.
Okay, thank you. That's all I wanted to know. Okay. Sorry I had to pull you out of class for that. Bye.
Regrow your mustache in you.
Fair enough. Okay. So. So let's get back to this. Was your question answered?
Yeah.
Okay. Is someone listening to music really loud on their cell phone?
I hear that too.
Did someone just turn their music down just a second ago?
About Nico.
Did someone, anyone just listen? Because it just stopped. Nico, was that you? You didn't just turn your music down?
No, I had it at the same volume.
You have it at the same volume?
What?
You see this? This is a chain. See all the links, how they link together?
Wow.
That was a look, a squirrel thing. All right. What is a corporation on 237? Let's do this again. The most complicated form of business is a corporation. A corporation is a business firm that is itself a legal entity. So what you guys are going to have to do, so the new word up here, again, this will be for final. You guys are going to need to know these terms. Oh, my God. That is not one of the terms. Oh, it's a term. Corporation, and you're going to need to know various aspects of corporation. Hey, can you guys put away your phones, please?
It's a business.
Mine's away.
What?
It's a business. Asking?
No, I was asking. I thought you were telling me you're conducting business on your phone.
No.
It's business. Don't bug me, Wallace. What is a corporation? Okay. Is a business firm that is itself a legal entity. See, here's the thing. When you have a sole proprietorship, if you open a business and you want to sell your ceramics, and I buy your ceramics and you tell me that it's microwave safe, and I use it and it blows up in the microwave as I'm pulling it out, and it shatters. This is how things work, okay? And it shatters. I can sue you individually, okay? I can, and if you can't pay me, if I sue you for $1 million and you don't have it, and we won our case, they will seize your assets. And they will squeeze the money out of you. And unless you know how to hide that money, how to be sneaky, it will bankrupt you and you might end up homeless. Okay? These kinds of things happen. When you have a corporation, so if I make millions and millions of dollars through my corporation, and I turn around and buy a 25,000 square foot house in a Ferrari, you can sue my corporation, but you're not going to get my house in Ferrari. Right? This is why people want to move to protect their assets will create corporations. It's one of the reasons why. It's not the only reason why. Okay? The other thing has to do with stocks. Okay. So we'll get to that. So it is a business firm that is itself a legal entity. That's a key word right there. Legal entity. What's that? This means that the law treats a corporation similarly to how it treats an individual human being. The corporation has certain rights and obligations, just as people do. So, for example, your corporation has to prove, it has to publicly, and in this case, publicly announce its taxes over a fiscal year. Okay? Because, and we're going to get to this in a second, a corporation is supported by shareholders. The corporation itself is owned by its stockholders. So what's a stockholder, Andrew? So I have a corporation, Wallace Industries, and I'm going to sell reading glasses. You guys saw my reading glasses, and you guys were like, man, those are so cool. I want some of that tape holding them together. And I sell million, and you guys start wearing them, and one day Andrew leaves, and he has his bow tie and his glasses on, and says, dude, where'd you get those glasses? And it sweeps the nation, okay? So Andrew, no, I'm going to say Ernesto is some cat sitting in Des Moines, Iowa. And he's looking at the newspaper, he's looking at the business section of the newspaper, and he's reading the stock market. And he says, what is this, Wallace Industries? Man, they keep, every time I look at them, I see them in the newspaper, I notice their stocks keep going up. So he's going to buy my stocks. When he buys my stocks, he's part of my company, my corporation. He's part owner. You're not really an owner, but you kind of are. You own capital in this company. Is this making sense, guys? And what that allows me to do is now I'm going to, so I take that money that Ernesto and Tyler and Daichi, who live in other states, they're sending it through their stocks. That money comes back to my company, and I'm going to open another factory. Oh, heck, you know what? I'm going to open a factory in India to go exploit some poor third world people so I can make these things really cheap and make an even greater profit. So the next time Andrew opens up the newspaper, he sees, wow, look at these profits. And now Andrew wants to buy stocks. And now you become a shareholder. And what I do in return, because you guys aren't just giving me money, right? What do you guys want? Why do you give me money? You're not buying glasses. You want money too. So you want a share of my stock. So my profit margin, now that I'm producing these in a third world country, where I don't have to worry about regulations and stuff, and I can exploit third world labor, I can make these for a lot cheaper, which drives my profit margin up. But here's the thing. All these people are buying into my company. I think I'm going to take that money and I'm going to hide it. And I'm not going to report it. You guys see what's happening here? And what happens if I don't report it? I got the money, I got the profits, but now I don't have to pay out as much to you guys. So this is why they have to report honestly, and there's regulations, and if people don't meet these regulations, they get penalized. They get fined. Okay? Companies can get into a lot of trouble for this. I'm sorry, did you just fart or something?
No, I laughed when you said penal.
You know what? This is my fault. I do that all the time. I have myself to blame. What becomes, this is on page 237, right-hand side of 237, second paragraph. The corporation itself is owned by its stockholders. Do you have eyes in your ears? Your left ear specifically? One becomes a stockholder by purchasing shares of stock which represent partial ownership of the corporation. A certain number of shares are issued, and the percentage of the total shares owned by each stockholder is the proportion of the corporation that he or she owns. For example, suppose a corporation issues 100,000 shares of stock. One investor, Ernesto, purchases 10,000 of these shares. Because 10,000 is 10% of 100,000, Bill owns 10% of all the shares. That means he owns 10% of the corporation. If Bill owned all 100,000 shares, he would own the entire corporation. And this is why some corporations, when they have their shareholders meetings, things can happen, right? So let's say somebody represents our business, because I got to advertise these badass glasses, right? I want to advertise them. But I have somebody that I'm having advertise these glasses that the public doesn't like, because they express some political view, some social view that they don't agree with. Let's pick one. Let's say you guys are all shareholders in my company, and let's say you guys were all against the legalization of marijuana. So you guys all spoke out against it, okay? But what's that? Why? I didn't say, what if? What the hell? Why not? Okay. So, Nico represents, he's a good looking young man, right? And he wears these glasses, and here's the commercial. Bye, Wallace. Okay. So that's the commercial. But then on the side, Nico starts talking about making marijuana illegal. Oh, yeah. and he comes out, you know, he has public service announcements, and he writes a rap song about it. Don't smoke weed, you dweeb. Okay. All right. And then what happens, now here's the deal, though. Now we have our shareholders meeting. So Libby and Devin really like pot.
Oh.
And they want to see it legal. So here's what they tell me. I'm the CEO of the company, Chief Executive Officer, CEO. Okay? And their shareholders, we all meet down at a conference down in Disneyland. And they say to me, you know what? We don't want Nico representing us. He goes against, he is against what our basic kind of philosophical principles are in life. Now, Nico has a First Amendment right to free speech, right? But we're also a business. Our business isn't necessarily tied to his First Amendment right to free speech. He can speak all he wants, but we don't have to keep him employed. So what we tell him is, Nico, you keep talking about making marijuana illegal, we're going to fire your ass. And so Nico has a choice now. That's how a lot of court, that's how these things are starting to play out. You guys remember the whole thing about the Parkland shooting in Florida?
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, shareholders and people would threaten to stop buying at certain companies. Some shareholders got together and they said, you know what? You want to divest, you want to like not sell these guns. But we, because the people who support those businesses might be people, for example, who support the Second Amendment. They say, you guys do this, we're going to divest. We're going to take our money out of your company.
How can they do that?
They're part, well, I mean, you're, if you own 10,000 shares in Wallace Industries, is there a law that says you have to keep your $10,000 in my company? Do what you want with it. And what happens is, this is why they have these shareholder meetings. Y'all get together and you start talking. You guys are sitting, the meeting starts at noon. So you guys are going to meet at the bar at 10 o'clock, have a little drink. You guys start talking together and you say, hey, what's going on with Wallace Industries, man? What's, and then, you know, you start talking to Libby and Devin is sitting there. And you guys are like, what's up with this Nico guy who represents us, who keeps saying, make marijuana illegal? And you guys are like, yeah, we like weed. Let's keep it legal. That's how these things happen. And then you have the meeting at noon, got a couple beers in you. You have the meeting like, yo, CEO, make him stop. Or we're going to divest. You guys are going to go home today and say, parents are going to ask, what did you learn today? Mr. Wallace wants to legalize marijuana, I think. When one person or a small group of people owns all of a corporation, shares the business, is a private corporation by contract. You guys know who the Green Bay Packers are?
Yeah.
Yeah? You guys know who the Green Bay Packers are, right?
Football team.
Professional football team. Okay. Do you know who the owner of the Green Bay Packers are?
I know.
I'm setting you guys up right now. What do you guys think the answer is? You guys know who the, here, give you a hint, who the owners of the Green Bay Packers are?
People who watch them.
Nope. What? Not people who watch them.
People that coach them.
People that pay them.
Not people who coach, what?
People that pay
them. Taxpayers.
Nope.
People that pay them.
Nope.
People that pay them.
Give me that name. What are they called? Starts with an S.
Snakes.
Sellers. Shareholders.
The Sasquatches. Thank you.
Shareholders.
The shareholders. They are a publicly owned.
The shared decision makers.
They are a public, yeah. No, shareholders. They are a public, they are owned by people who have shares of stock. And the Green Bay Packers started off. The Green Bay packing plant was a meat packing plant. In the early 1900s, you got these big, mean farm boys from the Midwest who were working at this meat packing plant, and they were playing this new game called professional football. And that's why they're called the Green Bay Packers, because they were meat packers. Okay? They worked in slaughterhouses and stuff.
People
that this is back in the early 1900s. So on the side, they would play this sport. They would wear, you know, they would promote. And what they were advertisement, basically. These players were advertisement for the Green Bay packing plant. And they became professional football players. And they were paid, they were given money to play football and represent the meatpacking plant. So today, that model still exists. The people who own the Green Bay Packers, there aren't. You know, you guys know who owned the San Francisco 49ers? A guy named Jed York. Okay? One guy. He's the principal owner of the San Francisco 49ers. You guys know who owned the Sacramento Kings? You guys should know this. You guys been following any of the Stephon Clark Black Lives Matter stuff?
No.
No? Oh, well, the owner of the Sacramento Kings has come out, spoken out against injustice and said, we will commit money to Black Lives Matter. The owner of the Sacramento Kings, he's an Indian from Asia, India. His name is Ranadive is his last name. Okay? Green Bay Packers, shareholders.
How do you know all this?
How do I know all this? Because I read. Yeah. Seriously. I read. I'm interested in the world. I read the news. I follow the news. I'm not saying it like, you know, I'm not trying to be arrogant. That's why I really stress to you guys, one of the things I'm able to have now are conversations with my son. Because my son is starting to read a lot more. And so he'll catch himself. He'll have these arguments with me sometimes, and I'll say, you know, dude, I can't have this argument with you if you don't read. Read. Read about the economy. Whatever source you choose, even if it leads to a debate, if I don't agree with the information that I'll respond to it. But read. Find out. You don't like reading. Therein lies a problem. Okay, then listen. There's documentaries, there's news. Talk to people in the know about things, okay? The Green Bay Packers, I mean, this is, I like football, right? Tri-tai?
Yes.
So I read articles about football. And in reading, I watch documentaries. I knew about this because you guys know who Brett Favre is?
No.
No? The longtime quarterback for the Green Bay Packers. And when he left, he went to play for the Minnesota Vikings. He retired from the Packers and went to play for the Vikings. And people booed him, hated him in Green Bay because the Vikings are big-time rivals of the Green Bay Packers. And after he retired from football for good, he was invited back to Lambeau Field. That's a stadium in Green Bay. And all these fans who booed him and stuff, and they kind of let it go. All these fans were invited back for free because guess who they were, the ones who entered for free? They were the shareholders of the Green Bay Packers. Remember, Nico, who owns the Green Bay Packers?
Shareholders.
They were all there and they invited him back and everyone was crying and Brett Favre was crying. And I watched the documentary on it. I find that stuff interesting. How do I know about Stephon Clark? You guys been watching the news lately? You guys know that they have been shutting down Kings games? They've been shutting down freeways here in Sacramento. Do you guys not know that?
No.
Protests over... No?
No? No. I heard it.
You've heard it?
Oh, yeah. They're trying to stop all the protests and they're trying to stop it. Because people are jumping on the freeway and someone got run over. But I called his... The cop said they said they didn't have people to be doing it. They did not ask permission.
Well, that's the nature of a protest.
Yeah.
You don't ask for permission. A lot of people will protest in order to draw attention to something, and typically there should be something, a sacrifice, so to speak. You're willing to put yourself out there, getting arrested, getting beaten up, maybe getting killed, to protest, to advocate for a principle. Not school principle, right? A principle, an idea. That's why people protest. All right. Creating a corporation. So, you guys understand what a corporation is, yeah? All right. What's that?
What?
Everyone,
turn to page 243.
What?
243.
711.
Does this a bell ring?
1005.
This
is all.
Yeah?
Does it have to be at 1005?
Yeah.
Got it.
Hmm? Can I leave? Can you leave?
Yes.
1 minute early? You can't stay one freaking minute. Sure, you can go.
There's break after this.
There is break. If you guys want to hit the cafeteria, go hit the cafeteria.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye. Ernesto, thank you. Thank you.